In my previous video on duration, I showed how to pick bonds or funds based on bonds that have the greatest potential for capital gains by selecting the securities that have the longest duration. In doing that video, I realized that there was a simple way to calculate the potential for capital gains, so I will show you how to do that in this video. This video will start out by laying the foundation and the logic for my spreadsheet model that calculates potential capital gains. The foundation will indicate how to calculate present value and future value and how the prices of bonds are determined. It will discuss the relationship between duration and interest rates and how to use duration and zero coupon bonds to calculate the potential capital gains for any bond by using a spreadsheet model. I will also discuss how to ascertain when it will be the best time to buy based on my model. The beauty of using duration with bonds is that the potential capital gains for bonds can easily be calculated, something which is impossible to do for stocks. To know how bond prices vary with yield, you must first understand the idea of present value and future value. If I deposit $100 in a bank account paying 5% interest annually, then at the end of the first year, I will have $105. At the end of the second year, I will earn 5% on the $105, so I will have $110.25 at the end of the second year, thus earning 5% compounded annually. This is the generalized equation for calculating future value. From that equation, it is easy to calculate present value from the future value. Just divide both sides by the interest rate term. With bonds, future value equals the par value that will be received when the bond matures. The present value equals the bond price. The interest rate equals the bond yield. These are the five primary factors affecting bond prices. The main factors are interest rates and the credit rating of the issuer. The value of the bond equals the present value of coupon payments plus the present value of the face value. Present value depends on interest rates. Therefore, bond prices also depend on interest rates. This is the generalized equation for bond prices. As you can see, it is very similar to the formula for present value because the bond price equals the present value of all payments received from the bond issuer. The price of bonds move inversely to interest rates. When interest rates rise, bond prices decline, and vice versa. Duration depends primarily on market interest rates and the amount and timing of cash flows. It has always been observed that the interest rate sensitivity of bonds increases with the term of the bond, but different bonds with different cash flows had different sensitivities to interest rates, even if they had the same terms to maturity. I just produced a whole video on duration, but there are only two facts about duration you need to know for this video. First, interest rate sensitivity increases with the duration. Second, bonds or funds with the same duration will have the same interest rate sensitivity. Interest rate sensitivity is related to both interest rate risk and the potential for capital gains. Interest rate risk is highest when the federal funds rate is near zero and lowest when interest rates are at their peak. When interest rates are at their peak, then bonds have the greatest potential for capital gains, and this potential is commensurate with their duration. The longer the duration, the greater the potential for capital gains. Duration measures the interest rate sensitivity more accurately by incorporating the present value of the cash flows of the bond, discounted by the market yield. Think of it as the normalized term of a bond. Zero coupon bonds simplify the calculation of potential capital gains. Zero coupon bonds do not pay any coupons, hence the name. So the price of the bond depends only on the present value of its face value. The duration of the zero equals the term of the zero. This allows the construction of a spreadsheet model that can calculate how much a bond's price will change in response to a given change in interest rates for bonds that have the same duration. I'm going to use my spreadsheet model to calculate the potential capital gains for two exchange-traded funds, the long-term Treasury ETF and the extended duration Treasury ETF. Both securities are based on U.S. Treasuries and have a yield of about 4%. This is the basic information for VGLT. VGLT tracks 30-year Treasury bonds. Note that the average duration is about 16.3 years, and the 52-week price difference is 48%. EDV is based on U.S. Treasury strips, which are zero-coupon bonds created by forming new securities based on the coupon and principal payments of 30-year treasuries. For EDV, the average duration is 24.2 years, and the 52-week price variation is 75%. Note that EDV varies more in price during the year because it has a longer duration. Now we will start constructing the spreadsheet to do the calculations. For this example, we will start with the Vanguard Long Duration ETF. We first start off with a simple table with the future value of 100 and the stipulated duration of 24. Then we add two additional columns below. The first column lists interest rates, starting with the interest rate that is current when you purchase the investment. I set the lowest interest rate at 0.25% because the Federal Reserve has lowered it below that at least three times since 2009. The second column consists of the present value of the future value discounted by the interest rate for the number of years equal to the duration. Then put the value of the first present value into the cell listing your investment, because this is how much you would pay for the security given the current interest rate. We are not really interested in how much the amount is, only in how much it changes as interest rates change. You calculate the present value by using the formula on the screen. You put the formula in the first cell for the present value, making sure that the future value and the duration point to the same cells as you copy the formula downward. You can see on the screen how the formula is constructed in Microsoft Excel. Note the use of dollar signs to fix the reference to the future value and the duration. You don't need the next column, but I put it here to illustrate how much the price increases over the original price. The last column shows the net gain. You can see the formula and the spreadsheet construction on the screen. This screen shows the two spreadsheets for EDV and VGLT so that you can compare them side by side. In my previous video on duration, I compared these two securities for interest rate risk and for potential capital gains. By understanding duration, you can easily see that the potential for capital gains is much greater for EDV than for VGLT. But with this spreadsheet model, I am quantifying these capital gains. My approach is like the full valuation approach used by bond managers or portfolios. These spreadsheets show the potential net gains for each 1% decrease in interest rates. You can see that the gain for EDV is almost twice as much as the gain for VGLT if interest rates drop to 0.25%. The reason why the discrepancy is so large is because there's 8 years of difference in the duration of these two securities. The interest is compounded over those 8 additional years, which leads to a much bigger gain for EDV. Even if the interest rate only drops by 2%, it will still lead to a sizable increase in capital gains. Look at these potential gains. How long do you think it would take to earn the same return from the stock market, especially while interest rates are high? So how well does my spreadsheet model compare with the reality? To answer that question, we will look at how the two securities did from 2018 to the start of the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020. During that time, interest rates decreased from 2.4% down to 0.5%, a drop of 2.35%. So I have used a smaller table listing only the top interest rate and the lowest rate. First, we will look at VGLT. Currently, this security has a duration of 16, but when I plug that number into my model, it underestimates the gain by 10%. My model predicts a gain of 45%, while in actuality, VGLT gained 55%. However, I do not know what the duration was at that time, and I do not know how I could find that information. I will just note that plugging in a duration of 19 increases the net gain to almost the actual gain. It is to be expected that duration was longer in 2018 than it is currently because the coupon payments were lower in 2018, which increases duration. However, with EDV, my estimate of the net gain is much closer to reality. I predicted a gain of 75% compared to the actual gain of 74%. I want to point out that Vanguard maintains a long duration with EDV, since that is the purpose of that fund. But the duration of VGLT was probably longer in 2019, since that fund is composed of T-bonds with lower coupon rates. This explains why my model predicts the price increase of EDV very well, but underestimates the price increase for VGLT. In any case, you can easily see that EDV increased in price more than VGLT. The beauty of this investment is that it is based on U.S. Treasuries, so it will be free of credit default risk. This is one of the few investments that pays great interest, has an outstanding potential for capital gains, and yet it is virtually risk-free if purchased after interest rates have peaked. Compare this investment with dividend-paying stocks, which do not have nearly the same capital appreciation potential. If you think it is unlikely that the Fed funds rate will drop to near zero, below 0.25%, consider the fact that it has dropped below that rate three times since 2009. When will interest rates peak? The Federal Reserve wants to control interest rates to maximize employment while keeping inflation low. Right now, it is raising interest rates to combat inflation, but once inflation is subdued, then it will stop raising interest rates. Because inflation is still strong, the Federal Reserve will almost certainly continue raising interest rates at least a couple more times in 2023. The Federal Reserve has increased interest rates at each of its Federal Open Market Committee meetings, and it is expected to continue doing so for the next couple of meetings. The top signs that interest rates are at or near the top are when inflation has decreased to around 2%, and especially if the Fed starts pausing, raising interest rates. When interest rates peak, do not buy right away. Interest rates will stay high for at least a couple of months because it takes time to get feedback from the economy. Demand will often be up when the interest rates have just increased, but usually the price will drift downward after many people have already bought. After peaking, why will interest rates decline? Raising interest rates slows the economy, but it takes time for the effects to cascade throughout the economy, so it is hard to see how much it is tamping down inflation. Therefore, the Fed usually overshoots, causing a recession. Rising interest rates also cause an inverted yield curve and the recession that usually follows it. Check out my video on the inverted yield curve, where I discuss this much more extensively. Links are provided in the description. Remember that other factors affect bond prices, so interest rates are not the only determinant. Bonds will fluctuate in price even when interest rates do not change. But I hope this video will give you greater insight into the bond market and how you can profit the most from bonds. With interest rates so high and climbing even higher, bonds with long durations will be one of the best investments. Thank you very much for your time. If you liked my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I would appreciate any suggestions, so please leave them in the comments below. Check out my website at thismatter.com for more than 850 in-depth fundamental tutorials on personal finance, investments, and economics. Check out my books on money at williamspalding.com. Thank you.